how Lena is the woman I truly love.
But regardless of jealousy and intrigue,
Karen, open the door, please.
They will fight for their love until the end.
Mountaintop just to reach you, girl. I'll walk the longest road, no matter how far I go.
L-O-V-E-Y-O-U. Oh, yes, I L-O-V-E-Y-O.
As times changes, technologies grow, and so you need to be in the know.
We are looking into matters, technology and education.
We'll bring you tech news from all over the world.
Me, I understand science revolves around life.
Tech policies and programs, Take on Tech has your back. Coming to your screens every Saturday at 4:30 p.m. only on KBC Channel 1. Join me, Stephanie Ayeta, and Grace Gedaiga as we serve you with only the best tech updates the world over.
Thank you for choosing KBC Channel 1 to let you in on what has been happening in your country and beyond borders. Tonight, we stay on the campaign trail as we cover for you what is happening ahead of the 2022 general election. On the Azimio wing, the Jubilee Party has resolved to issue direct tickets to those candidates who do not have any opposition in their regions. We'll also be telling you about the final touches on the UDA nominations slated to happen tomorrow already. A bit of drama being witnessed in Embu County. We got our team scattered across the country. We'll be covering the UDA nominations for you live. But tonight, let's begin our night's coverage by letting you in on some of the stories that made headlines.
Viongozi wa kaunti zetu, pesa munazo, watu wa kufanya kazi munao. Jameni, unganisha mambo hayo mawili.
State of the Art Stadium. President Uhuru Kenyatta urges county governments to emulate Kenya Defence Forces' discipline and dedication in development projects. Stroke of luck, High Court nullifies degree requirement for members of parliament. Party primaries, chaos and confusion rock the exercise.
All All right, once again, welcome to the broadcast. And of course, just a quick reminder, tomorrow we will be dedicating our day's coverage to just bring you live action as the UDA nominations go on across the country. We got our team on the ground to be bringing us details of these events tomorrow. But for tonight, a lot indeed that is to be expected in our comprehensive news bulletin that begins right now. My name is Safina Cheng Omar. John Jacob Kiria is away on assignment, but I'll be doing this together with our sign language interpreter, Anne Wangeshi, and later on, Carol Njenga with the business and Karen Kibet with the latest from the world of sports. Now, on to our top story. President Uhuru Kenyatta has challenged the leadership of counties to emulate the Kenya Defense Forces, which has demonstrated unmatched development attributed to hard work, discipline, and dedication. Speaking during the commissioning of the Ulinzi Sports Complex in Langata, the president said the complex is a clear testimony of what resources in this country can do if put into proper use.
President Uhuru Kenyatta commended the Kenya Defense Forces for the work done on the Ulinzi Sports Complex in a span of 16 months, demonstrating unmatched development. Speaking during the commissioning of the complex, the head of state said over the years counties have been allocated resources and have the workforce to initiate major projects, but selfish interests have been the norm.
Yastahili, pia viongozi katika sehemu mbali mbali, aswa viongozi wa kaunti zetu, pesa munazo, watu wa kufanya kazi munao. Jameni, unganisha mambo hayo mawili, pesa na utenda kazi. Sio pesa na tumbo, pesa na utenda kazi. Na Kenya hii yaweza kufaulu kushinda viwango ambavyo dunia itashangaa.
The head of state hailed the construction of the world-class sporting complex that he said is a pride of this nation. The 7,500-seater complex will have a football pitch, athletics track, swimming pool, basketball, netball, and boxing arenas.
This complex, Your Excellency, will realize the long-cherished dream of broadening KDF sporting disciplines towards solidification of KDF sporting preeminence amongst regional and international sportsmen and women. For example, Your Excellency, we used to have one of the best hockey teams within the KDF, and we intend to bring it back, including rugby.
Sporting commands self-sacrifice, discipline, as well as determination to be a winner. It is an extra effort that separates the winner from the second place, hence the power of sports to change the world, the power to inspire and to unite. Indeed, this facility is a platform that promotes sports tournaments and opportunities to engage and interact with various actors in the sports industry.
The facility, which hosted an exhibition match between Ulinzi and Tusker, will also host the KDF Athletics Championship next week.
All right, moving this forward, Interior Cabinet Secretary Dr. Fred Matiang'i has dismissed those who are accusing him of targeting government opponents. Dr. Matiang'i, who was addressing chiefs at the National Chiefs Delegates Conference in Nyeri, said he has no apologies for discharging his duties.
Dr. Matiang'i said his ministry will continue to carry out its duties despite insults and ridicule directed at it by a section of political players. The CS, taking issue with politicians trying to mudsling his name and that of his principal secretary, instead asking them to stick to their lane.
Politics comes and goes. You have seen more than two elections, others three elections, and so on. Wakizungumza sijaa hii shabira kusema kibicho na Matiang'i ni kama hawatasema kitu.
Speaking at the same event, Interior Principal Secretary Dr. Karanja Kibicho defended his involvement in politics, saying he had a right to participate in civic affairs as a private Kenyan citizen. The chiefs were encouraged to maintain political neutrality while dealing with politicians during the electioneering period and not to shy away from performing their duties. Jerotich Kiperno for Prime Edition.
Thank you, Jerotich Kiprono, for that report. Now, along the corridors of justice, the High Court has nullified a requirement that members of parliament must have a university degree. Justice Anthony Mrima termed the requirement unconstitutional as there was no adequate public participation. He was ruling on a petition by voters Paul Masharia Wambui, Joseph Karanja Mushai, and David Kimani Njenga. The ruling that comes in the wake of the ongoing political parties' primaries offers a big relief to political aspirants who do not have that academic qualification. All right. Still staying on matters politics, the Orange Democratic Movement Party gubernatorial aspirant for Siaya County, George Mbeya, on Wednesday suffered a big blow after learning that he was not among the configured to contest in the voting machines. Mbeya accused the party of keeping him and his supporters in the dark on the party primaries.
George Mugoye Mbeya, who was to contest in the nominations with Siaya Senator James Orengo for ODM Siaya County gubernatorial ticket, left Gombe Komolo Primary School in North Alego Ward a dejected man. This is after learning that his name was not configured in the nomination machines. Mbeya is now accusing the party of taking him and his supporters for a ride, as no party official had communicated to him that the position for which he applied and paid nomination fees will not be contested.
I surprised, the kit was working, it was open, my details are available, but I was informed that the gubernatorial position is not available on the gadget, as well as the Senate. It is surprising and shocking that even as of yesterday, the ODM party was still categorical that nominations are still going to be carried out.
Voting kicked off in other parts of Siaya County with a number of contestants exuding confidence that the will of the members will prevail.
I want to urge my people that there are a few technical challenges, but they are being resolved. They will be resolved, and I'm optimistic that at the end of the day, the will of the people of Lagos Wanga is going to be demonstrated in this ballot.
Meanwhile, Jubilee Party has resolved to issue direct tickets to candidates in areas where there is only one aspirant.
As we issue the certificates this evening to those who are with us today, it is also good to know that from tomorrow, the certificates will continue being issued from across the country. From our various branches, we will continue issuing others from here. We are also encouraging those who have not yet gotten to consensus to continue on that route. We said it before, I want to repeat again, that negotiated democracy has become part of our way of managing our political affairs.
Lakini pia niwape imani kwamba wale wengine ambao labda wamepingwa na wengine hapa na pale, kuna yale mazungumzo ambayo inaendelea, na tunajua kwamba hivi karibuni wote tutakuwa na maafikiano, hivi kwamba tutakuwa na wale ambao watapeperusha bendera yetu ifikapo tarehe 22 kama ilivyowekwa katika sheria zetu.
The party secretary general Jeremiah Kioni also affirmed the party's support for the Azimio One Kenya coalition, warning their aspirants against supporting rival political outfits.
We belong to the Azimio coalition. We do not want any of our candidates campaigning for any other formation other than Azimio. If we get the information that you are doing it, you are campaigning for other formations other than Azimio, we will recall the certificate.
Elsewhere, the Wiper Party has conducted its ward nominations in some areas of Mombasa County, whilst promising its members the exercises will be free and fair. Mombasa branch chairman Sheikh Twaha said the exercise started at 10 a.m., 4 hours late, to allow members who did not have their membership card to vote using the IDs and voters' card.
Mombasa County, tulikuwa na Mbogo, ambaye ndio alikuwa kama candidate wetu wa governor, na hakupewa direct ticket, bali kwa vile alikuwa ni yeye, akapewa interim ticket akonayo. So kupewa interim ticket haina maana wewe ndio usha qualify ama ushapewa certificate. Kuweza tokea anything kwa chama.
Aspirants under the Wiper Party have called on politicians to desist from utterances that may cause chaos.
Tuwekeni amani, kwa sababu tumeona hii michujo ambayo imeanza tayari kuna hali ya sitofahamu ambazo zimeanza, hali ya rapture, hali ya kutumia vijana kwa vibaya, na nadhani hiyo si demokrasia. Kubali kama wewe umeshindwa.
The exercise took place simultaneously in areas of Old Town in Mombasa, Chuda in Kisauni, Changamwe in Changamwe constituency, and Bofu in Likoni constituency.
All right, drama erupted in Embu town as youth confiscated a lorry transporting ballot boxes for United Democratic Alliance nominations and burnt the materials. The rowdy youths alleged that one of the gubernatorial aspirants was planning to rig the nominations set for tomorrow. UDA National Elections Board Chairperson Anthony Mwaura, however, assured aspirants of a free and fair process in all the 36 counties where nominations will be conducted.
Normalcy was interrupted at Embu town when rowdy youths impounded a vehicle transporting UDA nomination materials and destroyed materials they perceived were to be used to rig the nominations. A tough contest has ensued between nominated MP Cecily Mbarire and Manyata MP John Moshiri for UDA gubernatorial ticket.
We are reliably told that the county returning officer has resigned his position because of the intimidation he is getting from higher offices, whatever higher offices those may be. We have no idea.
Na police wachukue hatua kulingana na sheria. Sasa wao ndio wameongoza katika kuchoma hiyo material ya nomination kesho.
In Nakuru, UDA aspirants and supporters took to the streets accusing the incumbents and party officials of scheming to predetermine the nominations. The protesters marched to the party's county offices seeking audience with the branch officials, only to find the premises deserted.
We are here as Gilgil people to protest and reject in toto the recruitment process that has been that happened in the party of UDA.
The drama resulted in UDA National Elections Board Chairperson Anthony Mwaura announcing postponement of the exercise in Nakuru Town West as party prepares for the exercise tomorrow. 8 million members of the United Democratic Alliance in 36 counties will take to the ballot Thursday to elect candidates who will fly the UDA party flag in the August general elections.
This does not mean that we don't have candidates elsewhere. It is just that we have been conducting other modes of nominations, identifying our candidates through other various methods which this board is mandated to use.
The William Ruto-led party will conduct nominations in 981 electoral seats countrywide. 13 counties will nominate governors, while 18 counties will identify their senatorial candidates. 28 counties will nominate woman representative, and 138 constituencies will nominate candidates for member of National Assembly. Gishoke Washira, Prime Edition.
Away from that and back to the corridors of justice, a 22-year-old man has been ordered to pay a fine of 100,000 shillings or serve a one-year jail term for stealing cooking oil and other assorted goods worth 3,165. Alvin Chivondo admitted to the charge, but in his defense, he said that he was simply trying to fend for his family after going hungry for 3 days. Meanwhile, 15 suspects accused of stoning Raila Odinga's helicopter have been freed due to lack of evidence.
With teary eyes, 22-year-old Alvin Chivondo pleads with the court. Appearing before Milimani Chief Magistrate Wendy Mishemi, Chivondo was sentenced to 1 year in jail or pay a fine of 100,000 Kenyan shillings for stealing cooking oil and other assorted goods worth 3,165 Kenyan shillings. On the 10th of April at Naivas Development House supermarket, he stole some rice, honey, tea leaves, cooking oil and sugar. Chivondo told the court he did it all for his family. Meanwhile, the Employment and Labour Relations Court has issued orders stopping National Social Security Fund, NSSF, from recruiting 8 new general managers and others. In a petition filed by the Consumer Federation of Kenya through lawyer Henry Kurauka, the court ruled that the human resource instruments used to recruit the managers were ineffective since they were not approved by the Public Service Commission. The instruments are to be presented to the Public Service Commission within 21 days from the date of judgment. Elsewhere, an Eldoret court has released 15 people accused of stoning Raila Odinga's helicopter due to lack of evidence. Two of the accused will, however, remain behind bars pending prosecution. Serafina Robi for Prime Edition.
All right, and that report by Serafina Robi is taking us to our first break. But very quickly, Devi Osunkuli, thank you for watching. We also have George Kerempe. You say that you're watching from Ewasonyiro, Narok County. Collins Bett, also thank you. And Rose Kasichana, you're watching from Serengeti. We appreciate your time. Use the hashtag Prime Edition and also just follow us on social media at KBC Channel 1. We are going to be coming back with much more. Don't go too far.
For me, it's a great joy. It is also a very humbling occasion because it means, in effect, that Kenyans have given me a challenge to go ahead and fulfill all those things that I personally have been promising and our party has been promising. I want to assure you, the government that we are going to form in the next few days will be a government of national unity. As soon as Parliament reconvenes, bring the law, we should establish the Anti-Corruption Act.
Thank you guys for watching. Mini Flaco, an online content creator. Some time ago, I was hacked. And these hackers used my information to create several other accounts. Wakasambaza pictures and messages all over, pretending it's me. Shortly, there are a few more hundred Flacos in Kenya. What?
Being fooled online? Get CyberSmart to enjoy safe entertainment and education online. The Communications Authority of Kenya. Mawasiliano Kwetu, Nguvu Kwako.
Do you have a new story to share with KBC? Get in touch swiftly on email news@kbc.co.ke or call 0723-892-654 or 0734-780-124.
A true love in which family will be the main hardship to achieve happiness.
Well, I understand it, Mom, but I don't want to break up with Adrian.
Paulina will have to confront her own father. And Adrian will suffer due to his sister Julieta's obsession.
No! Not with-
with her! No! Not with her! No!
Helena is the woman I truly love!
No.
But regardless of jealousy and intrigue...
Karen, open the door, please!
They will fight for their love until the end.
Welcome back, and thank you once again for staying with us. Now, the National Assembly leader, Minority John Mbadi, has accused a section of politicians of peddling lies about the proposed tax measures in the next fiscal year. Mbadi says politicians opposed to the handshake are playing populist politics with the tax proposals in the Finance Bill 2022 that are still being processed.
Days after the United Democratic Alliance Party pledged to rally its troops in Parliament to oppose the Finance Bill 2022, consequently shooting down proposals in the 2022-2023 budget, the leader of minority in the National Assembly, John Mbadi, has faltered the move, claiming those opposed to the bill are being dishonest and are seeking to thrive in populist politics.
From 2013, check any finance bill that has been presented in the House. All of them have proposals or attempts to change the VAT on certain basic commodities. And he has never, ever complained. He has never, ever opposed such proposals. And as a leader of minority, our members in the Finance Committee are already briefed and have instructions that any proposal in the finance bill that is going to affect the prices of any basic commodity would not be accepted.
The Suba South lawmaker says those opposing the finance bill were being behind the passage of previous value-added tax measures through the infamous tyranny of numbers that hiked the price of commodities. According to Mbadi, the Finance Committee will provide solutions to the high cost of living.
We are already seeing with our own eyes that there's going to be a spike in prices of basic commodities. You cannot accept again as people's representative to subject Kenyans to more miseries.
The government, however, maintains that the country has enough fuel. Meanwhile, the House is divided over the proposals in the Huduma Bill 2021, saying it risks discriminating Kenyans without IDs and scrap the immigration department.
If this Huduma bill will be able to do away with some departments and some people earning salaries, Honorable Speaker, then it will have assisted us in reducing our wage bill, which we are even struggling with, Honorable Speaker.
And I think what this needs to be done is that this bill needs to be withdrawn for its entirety from Parliament. We go back to the drawing board, take inherent risk, because, you see, denying one Kenyan a right of access, or, you know, denying one Kenyan to be included, you know, it's like denying the whole world, as far as I'm concerned, Mr. Speaker, because the right of an individual is very, 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 very important.
So nobody needs to feel threatened that with the Huduma number, they'll be left out. In fact, we should all be celebrating that with the coming of the Huduma number, every Kenyan will actually be registered.
The Speaker has since directed that all the new amendments be forwarded to the clerk for harmonization and debate when the House resumes from recess in May. For Prime Edition, I'm Gladys Mungai.
Now on to matters education. Education Cabinet Secretary Professor George Magoha has urged parents to be contented with the Form 1 placements given to their children, saying the exercise was done in a fair manner. Professor Magoha was in Murang'a County to commission a competency-based curriculum classrooms, defended the system, saying it will produce all-round learners.
With 1.2 million students set to report to secondary school to begin Form 1 from 3rd of May, Education Cabinet Secretary Professor George Magoha has asked parents to be satisfied with the schools in the placement.
If you are a middle level Kenyan who can afford a private school, instead of going to drink whiskey in the high clubs, please take your child to a private school.
Professor Maguha, who spoke at Mochugucha Secondary School in Murang'a County, confirmed the construction of a CBC classrooms countrywide is at 92%.
It is extremely important that as we start to roll out the second phase of this program, all the children are kept at the same level. And that's why even here in Murang'a, where they're at 90%, they must complete by the 20th of this month.
At the same time, he said the government affirmative fund for children in the informal settlements has brought on board 9,000 beneficiaries who shall be admitted to schools of their choice.
We are very, very proud, and credit goes to His Excellency the President, who directed us to the slums and also directed us to ensure that we had affirmative action for all children in the slums. And I may also end that the President did not stop there. He directed us to, he provided money for 9,000 students.
Frederick Mwoki for Prime Edition.
And now the constitutional commissions and independent offices are asking for more allocation to enable them discharge their mandate effectively. Chief Justice Martha Koome says despite the shrinking budgets, the independent offices have ensured that service delivery remains at the core of operations. Ruth Wamboi with more details of this.
Constitutional commissions and independent offices are celebrating their 10th year anniversary with a call on Parliament to allocate them more money. The independent bodies argue that a lot can be achieved with adequate funding and respect for their authority.
Anybody who has an order issued against them to obey and implement that order of the court, it does not impact on us today, it impacts on us even in the future.
Chief Justice Martha Koome said there is need to cure legal challenges which are often brought about by lack of quorum in commissions.
People, we are trying to roll them out. Were it not for finances, we would at least have 100 small claims courts all over the country by now, but because of resources, we only have 11.
It is that we get only funded in the election year, as it happened this particular year, so that all the activities for between the last election and the last year, are we don't manage to do anything.
The other issue, of course, is like the judicial fund, if I may speak to the Judicial Service Commission. There's always been an issue of budget deficits, and most of the commissions are being challenged by this.
At the same time, the officers want the streamlining of their reporting procedures to avoid duplication.
Even when the law is clear, but the institutions that were used to handle certain matters and letting go is a bit of a problem.
It's important that, for example, those of us are here as a cluster could then be meeting those parliamentary committees, because that is where really we can discuss the issues together, so that as we are working together in CCIOs, we can then also present our cases as CCIOs and not separately as
They have further pledged to continue working in synergies for the benefit of the country. Ruth Wamboi for Prime Edition.
Right, and it's like a dream come true for Superstars Kids, a team of talented dancers who have landed an opportunity to perform for cash. Little did they know that this chance could be their ticket to losing their freedom. Superstars is the movie we feature tonight in our segment, Cinemas and Theatre.
When Eva, aged 9, and her friends enter Superstars dance competition, their focus is to win the prize money of 150,000 shillings. Unbeknown to them, they are a target of child traffickers.
We will need a team to go.
All Eva and her friends want to do is to join the Superstars dance competition, put their best foot forward, and win 150,000 shillings. So does 10-year-old Babji and his friends on the other side of town. However, in the heart of Mathare, a child trafficking ring eyes the competition as a source for its next victims. The film shot in Nairobi's Mathare and Kibera slums had more than 150 people involved in its making.
The issue of child trafficking has been really bad, especially during the COVID time, 2020-2021. We saw a significant increase in child trafficking cases and kidnappings. And so the DCI felt that there was need, first of all, to sensitize the masses about the child protection unit, which exists in every police station. And they also wanted to sensitize people about the phone number which people can call in case there's a missing child. You can call 0800-722-03 to report to the DCI.
Produced by Christine Savin and directed by Oprah Oyugi, the film Superstars key cast members are part of Anno's One Fine Day, a children's art program that empowers children through creative arts, dance, music, ballet, creative writing, drama, acrobatic, African and contemporary dance.
We first asked them to create dances. So we asked all the children to come up with dances and choreograph dances for themselves. In regards to the acting itself, we engaged one of the teachers again at Anno's One Fine Day, the drama teacher. We approached him and asked him to be the acting coach. We were very deliberate in not giving the scripts to the children because we were worried they would cram it. And once kids cram things, it's very hard for them to let go. To be honest, they superseded our expectations.
150K! Wow, wow, wow.
Competition.
A dance competition.
Yes. Alibook ticket ya kwenda Nairobi juzi. Most likely, you go kwa indoors wake pale Mathare.
For people who did not get a chance to attend either of the screenings, we are going to have a cinema run over Easter. So starting Friday this week, right until next week Thursday, we will have a cinema run in Prestige Cinemas. So we encourage adults to take their children to watch this movie because it's very much a movie for children as it is for adults.
The children dance their hearts out, but when they get off stage, they are pursued by the kidnappers. The DCI Child Protection Unit is on the trails of one of the kidnappers. Will they get to the event and arrest the criminals on time? Will Eva be reunited with her friends? Jacqueline Masharia for Cinemas and Theatre.
Pertinent questions there being asked by Jacqueline Masharia. Great reporting there. The movie Superstars. We feature this segment each and every week on Wednesday, Cinemas and Theatre, just appreciating local talent, producers and actors and actresses right here in Kenya. Now let's move this forward. Kenya and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia has committed to deepen and expand their long-standing and warm relationship for the mutual benefit of the two nations. Foreign Affairs Minister Rachel Omamo says that the two nations will in the next 2 weeks hold a virtual meeting to explore available trade and investment opportunities. Zainab Said now reports.
Foreign Affairs Minister Rachel Omamo noted that Kenya and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia had long-standing ties and are ready to move the friendship to a new high.
The meeting, the two noted, the long-standing and warm relationship between the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and the Republic of Kenya and express the desire to continue to deepen and expand that relationship for the mutual benefit of our two countries.
In the next 2 weeks, the two nations will hold talks to explore how to cooperate on trade and investment opportunities.
His Excellency the President and the Special Envoy also agreed to host a virtual investment conference between Kenya and the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia within the next 2 weeks.
expressing the country's support and participation in the upcoming Expo 2030 to be held in Riyadh. Momo said Kenya will partner with Saudi Arabia to combat climate change, sentiments echoed by visiting Minister of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Ahmed bin Katan.
In this regard, Kenya expressed her unequivocal support for Saudi Arabia's bid and candidature for the hosting of the Expo 2030.
Thank the President and to thank the government of Kenya on behalf of my government for supporting Saudi Arabia to host Expo 2030.
For Prime Edition, I'm Zainab Said.
Ili kupata warumi nane kama Skiza Tune kwenye simu yako, bonyeza star 811 star 815 hash.
Nina hakika kwamba hakuna kinachoweza kukutenga na upendo wa Mwenyezi Mungu. Si kifo, si malaika, si vitu tulivyokuwa navyo au tutakavyokuwa navyo. Si mamlaka au chochote kitakachoumbwa. Warumi 8:38 hadi 39.
Kupata Warumi 8, bonyeza star 811 star 815 hash. Star 811 star 815 hash.
As times changes, technologies grow, and so you need to be in the know.
We are looking into matters technology and education.
We bring you tech news from all over the world.
Me, I understand science revolves around life.
Tech policies and programs, Take on Tech has your back. Coming to your screens every Saturday at 4:30 p.m. only on KBC Channel 1. Join me, Stephanie Ayeta, and Grace Gedaiga as we serve you with only the best tech updates the world over.
Welcome back. We now take a look at the world, or rather the business of the news business tonight. And Kenya is developing a labor migration system that will help in the management of Kenyan migrant workers. The system will help track all the activities of migrant workers, like change of salaries and profile of employees. Labor Cabinet Secretary Simon Chelugui says the government is upgrading the labor market information system. O'Brien Kimani has more details from the 11th Connected Kenya Summit.
Kenya is battling a crisis of unemployment, with more than 1 million young people joining the labor market every year. This has seen the unemployment rate in the country jump to 15%, resulting in a huge informal sector that now employs more than 80% of the country's workforce. According to the Ministry of Labour, majority of these workers in the informal sector have low ICT skills. Labour Cabinet Secretary Simon Chelugui says, under the planned labour market information system, employers can obtain information on the skilled manpower joining the labour market, like graduates from various training institutions, skills inventory, and skilled manpower distribution in both the public and the private sectors.
We must all together bridge the digital divide and ensure that everyone benefits from the innovation of ICT sector.
Speaking at the 11th Connected Kenya Summit, CS Chelugui has said they have started a campaign under the National Industrial Training Authority to upskill ICT capacities among MSMEs. A study conducted by the ministry indicates that only 6% of workers in the informal sector have ICT skills.
The ministry is also currently upgrading the Kenya Labour Market Information System so that we can be able to mine data from other systems and be in position to generate up-to-date labor market indicators.
The ICT Authority has also told the conference that it has partnered with various public and private sector players to enhance ICT skills of more than 100,000 SMEs. The four-day Connected Kenya Summit is expected to end tomorrow. O'Brien Kimani for Primetime Edition.
The Route to Food initiative says the current hunger crisis in Kenya can only be mitigated by investing in making food accessible, reduced post-harvest losses and food wastage in the country's main food baskets. Here is Benson Rioba with the details.
In this year's 3.3 trillion shillings budget, agriculture was allocated 47 billion shillings, which is 13 billion shillings less from the budgetary allocations for the current financial year. Players in the agriculture sector are faulting the government for not adhering to the Malabo Declaration that requires signatory countries to allocate at least 10% of their national budgets to agriculture, noting that this would enhance food security and reduce food prices.
The issues with, of course, imports that come from, you know, countries that have been affected by the Russia-Ukraine conflict, it's, you know, that should be awareness enough that we have to invest in our own food. You know, when you're not able to buy food and you have a small farm, you are supposed to take it into your mind very quickly that now it's time for me to start producing my own food. If you can't get potatoes from the market, then it tells you that as a person, you need to grow your own potatoes. So
they attribute the current hunger crisis in parts of the country to underfunding of the agriculture sector.
If we don't invest in our food and farming systems, if we don't invest in agriculture systems, if we don't invest in these areas where producers produce, then we of course are looking at a health burden. And after the health burden, we are looking at an economic burden.
They want the Ministry of Agriculture to allocate large amounts of the budget to strengthening the food systems and accessibility through proper linkages between farmers and consumers.
Do wish that we get good infrastructures to ensure that food from farm can reach a consumer as in the state that is fit for consumption.
Last year, Kenya food imports stood at 155.42 billion shillings, with the amount projected to increase this year due to poor rains. Benson Rioba reporting for Prime Edition.
Now, entrepreneurs eyeing the fast-growing on-demand laundry market can now access financing to venture into the laundromat business. This follows a deal between LG Electronics, Avana Laundromats, and Hotpoints that seeks to create jobs for more Kenyans while offering laundry solutions to a growing middle-income class. Here are the details of this and other stories in our corporate roundup.
With less than 20% of Kenyan homes owning a washing machine or dryer, commercials laundromats, popularly known as dry cleaners, are set to offer investors and clients a smarter, safer way of doing laundry. Besides financing, the deal will offer franchising opportunities for interested entrepreneurs. The laundromat technology is equipped with a digital app that allows operators to manage their businesses off-site in real time and promptly track and resolve technical issues.
We were looking for somebody who would be able to offer franchising and financing solutions to people who would want to open their own laundromat.
In order to open the, you know, this opportunity to the, you know, the small and middle-sized, you know, the entrepreneurs they want to, you know, enter into. In this kind of the business, we want, you know, to introduce about, you know, this kind of the business scheme. And secondly, we want, you know, to give the, you know, the experience to the, you know, the end customer.
Meanwhile, the Kenya National Chamber of Commerce and Industry, Mombasa chapter, has signed an MOU with the Ugandan consulate to strengthen bilateral ties. Ugandan Consulate General to Kenya, Paul Mukumbia, expressed his optimism that the deal will build trust, access and expertise that will help local business find new resources and opportunities.
This MOU provides a platform for further collaboration between the Kenya National Chamber of Commerce in Mombasa and the Consul General of Uganda. You know, we look forward to a lot more successful events and further collaboration and bringing the business numbers up.
The Agribusiness Symposium and the exhibition that we held last year
was made to see how the two countries can better cooperate, one, to enhance trade, but also two, to deal with the bottlenecks, the tariff and non-tariff barriers that were hindering the smooth flow of trade.
Finally, farmers in Migori County risk losing their produce after armyworms invaded their farms, destroying maize, sorghum and millet crops, as well as pasture. The farmers claim their efforts to reach the county officials have not borne fruits, as most officers are on political campaigns.
Na yao wadudu wameharibu shamba yote. Sasa hata safari hii hatuna hata haja ya kupalilia, kwa sababu hakuna kitu vile mnaweza kuona. Imekula kila kitu, na hapa tukilima vizuri na tuvune vizuri, tunapata mahindi kama gunia 50 ama 50 na kitu. Lakini mara hii ni kama tunaenda kutoka bure.
Nalima na mbegu nimenunua na mbolea. Nimeweka watu wa kibarua wamebadilia mahindi. Sasa nikilala siku mbili mimi naenda hakuna mahindi kwa shamba. Nimeshangaa.
For Prime Edition, I am Teresa Mutai.
The National Cooperative Housing Union, NACHU, has tapped a real estate firm, Fisco Africa, to launch a 400-acre project located in Ruiru, Kiambu County, targeting homeowners in Nairobi metropolitan area. Fisco Africa CEO John Mwaura says the gated community project targets to feed into the affordable housing agenda of the government and address the housing deficit in the country.
Data shows that over 5 million households live in rental homes. Most of them rent houses in urban areas, while 900,000 rent houses in rural areas. The housing deficit in Kenya has been at 200,000 units annually and growing. To address this, the National Cooperative Housing Union has tapped real estate firm Finsco Africa to launch a 400-acre project located in Ruiru, Kiambu County.
What we were doing is calling our existing client and new clients to have conversation with them, sort of have a land clinic day for them, because we understand the need for Kenyans and clients to have a little bit of information about land processes.
Finsco Africa CEO John Mwaura said the housing project is also a social impact initiative, as it seeks to provide affordable housing for low and middle income earners.
A gated community is a controlled gated community. We are going to have a social whereby people are not going to do the type of houses they wish and do them without consulting. Give us your wish, but come, we try to talk. We tell you this is the kind of house that we are allowing here.
He is encouraging Kenyans to join or form cooperatives, circles, and saving groups to purchase land or build houses. For Prime Edition, I am Teresa Mutai.
And that story brings to a close business news for tonight. Karen Kibet is coming up next with a sports update. My name is Carol Jenger. Have a good night. See you tomorrow for more business news.
Stadion in Berlin is now less crowded, with only 4 teams out of 64 still in contention. Something more outstanding is that all of the sides to have won the DFB Pokal over the last 29 years are already out this year.
And Leverkusen are knocked out by a Bundesliga 2 side.
In the first DFB Pokal semi-final, Hamburger SV will face Freiburg on Tuesday, the 19th of April 2022 at 9:45 p.m. While in the second semi-final, RB Leipzig will lock horns with Union Berlin on Wednesday, the 20th April 2022 at 9:45 p.m. Having braced the turbulent journey and buoyed up with the trophy in sight, no team want to go down without a fight. You don't want to miss this adventurous football show, live and exclusive on KBC Channel 1. KBC Channel 1, your true sports partner.
Oh, my soul.
Welcome back to Prime Edition. I do hope your evening is treating you well. Let's now delve into sports matters. My name is Karen Kibet. Now, the Kenya National Women's Deaf Basketball Team is targeting a top five finish at the 24th Summer Deaf Olympics, set to be held from the 1st to the 15th of next month in Brazil. The team's first appearance at the prestigious event was in 2017 in Turkey, where they finished 8th.
Kenya National Women Deaf Basketball Team hopes to finish in the top five at the 24th Deaf Olympics in Brazil. The team's first appearance at the event was in 2017 in Turkey, where they finished 8th and were awarded a diploma certificate thanks to their outstanding performance on their debut. Assistant coach Hilda Indasia says they do not want to set unrealistic targets, having been pulled in Group B alongside the United States, Turkey, Lithuania and Ukraine. Group A comprises of hosts Brazil, Greece, Italy and Poland.
We know it's a big challenge ahead of us. We know it's going to be, we're going to need to work so hard, and we are really hoping to improve from what we had done the past Deaf Olympics in 2017.
While 20 players are in camp at Moi International Sports Center Kasarani in Nairobi, only 12 will travel to Brazil for the games, with Captain Mercy Mideva saying they are not intimidated by their powerhouse opponents as they look to improve their ranking in the world. Kenya is ranked 9th globally in the women's deaf basketball.
We have been doing drills, the training has been going on well, and our coach will be choosing the best players to represent the team and the country in Brazil.
Kenya National Men's Deaf Basketball Team are in Group A alongside Israel, United States, Argentina and Poland. Group B has Lithuania, hosts Brazil, Greece, Venezuela, Chinese Taipei and Ukraine.
Thank you, Buckley, for that report. Moving on, this year's Africa Rugby Under 20 Bats Cup will have a new champion. After holders and hosts Kenya were eliminated in the semi-finals after going down 16-5 to Namibia at the Nyayo National Stadium. It was an intense game from the first minute, with Chrysander Antonio Botha charges scoring a converted try plus three penalties, while Curtis Olago charges scored an unconverted try. Leading 6-0 at halftime, Namibia's captain Ryan Groove was the man of the match with 11 points from three penalties and a conversion. The Court of Arbitration for Sports has upheld an appeal filed by the Athletics Integrity Unit and banned 2014 Commonwealth Games gold medalist Joyce Chepkiri for 4 years, starting on the 28th June 2019, for an athlete a biological passport violation.
The AIU filed the appeal after the Sports Dispute Tribunal ruled that Chepkirui had not committed any offence in November 2019. In their appeal, the AIU sought to have the decision of the SDT overturned by CAS following an assessment of the changes in Chepkirui's blood sample profile over time. Chepkirui claimed that the use of iron supplements for medical purposes had led to an increase in her hemoglobin levels, a claim that was disputed by a panel of experts. The sanction means that Chepkirui loses all awards and records gained from the 6th of April 2016 until the 4th of August 2017. In addition, Anti-Doping Agency of Kenya, listed as a third respondent, has been ordered to bear the cost of arbitration and pay 250,000 Kenya shillings to World Athletics as contribution to its legal costs and other expenses incurred in the present proceedings. For Prime Edition, I am Daniel Wahome.
Thank you, Wahome, for that report. Now, finally, the last two semi-final slots of the UEFA Champions League will be filled tonight when Manchester City travel to Atletico Madrid and Liverpool host Benfica. City lead the aggregate score by a goal to nil, while Liverpool are in a commanding position, having won 3-1 in the first leg. The two winners will join Real Madrid and Villarreal in the semi-final.
English Premier League. Meanwhile, Liverpool will be defending their 3-1 goal.